Hey everybody, Bud Brown here, living in Dumaguete City, Philippines. Yeah, baby. I love it here. Look who's with me. It's Betsye.
Hi.
So, a lot of the subscribers had questions for Betsye because it's not so common to see an American lady living here in the Philippines, at least not here in Dumaguete anyway. So we got a few questions I wanted to ask her.
Sonny, who I worked with, and he's Filipino, and I was doing my research for my retirement knowing that I couldn't stay in America, it was too expensive. And Sonny kept prompting me to check out the Philippines, so I did. And what I found after much research is that I loved it. Loved the people, the cost of living is very reasonable,
yeah.
But mainly the weather, the people, the feeling of the Philippines,
yeah,
is like nothing else.
Now you're from
Mississippi.
So how are you finding the weather? A lot different or same or?
I find it not as hot.
Not as hot.
Amazing.
There you go.
I'm finding it not as hot as it sounds. The heat is a bit different here. It's not humid, but our heat is so intense in Mississippi. But I'm finding it very pleasant. I'm
okay.
Not having a problem with the heat.
Okay. Yeah. Now, on your research, were there some things that were confirmed when you got here, or some things that just completely caught you off guard?
The thing that really caught me off guard was the food. So far, I'm having a little bit of a problem with the food.
Mm-hmm.
But
I've heard people say that. Yeah.
Maybe I just haven't eaten in the right restaurants or whatever.
Yeah.
So I'm still on the search for good food.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. That's
find it.
That's
but,
not unheard of. Yeah.
I think I'm finding the people much friendlier than I thought. I knew they would be friendly.
Uh-huh.
But they're warm and they're helpful.
Yeah.
And polite.
Yeah.
And very agreeable. They have a niceness about them that I just love.
You had a lot of help when you first got here because of unexpected, not necessarily me, but the Filipinos.
When I landed in Cebu, I had a few major crises like missing my flight. And it seems to be that the minute I stepped off the airplane in Cebu, there were just people helping me. Because my phone didn't work, they were glad to lend me their phones. Helped me through the airport. One little porter stayed with me the entire time. You know, just so helpful, and I was so lost. So had it not been for those nice, helpful people, it would have been really bad for me. Bad.
Now you have advice for somebody coming over about maybe a telephone?
Well, one thing I thought all you had to do was change your SIM card, but it's a little more complicated.
Okay, that's a good lesson. That's a good lesson.
You have to put load on it, and I had no idea what load was.
Yeah.
Bring more money, because it's much more expensive than I assumed it was going to be.
Right,
deposits and odds and ends and things like that. So bring more money than you had thought you were going to bring. You're going to need it.
That's a good idea.
And find a wonderful helper like I have found, Jackie.
Yeah.
Because you cannot do this by yourself.
Right.
You have to have someone to guide you through it.
Jackie is a Filipina lady that got together with Betsye, and now they're, the two amigos. And she's a real, from my channel that Davina has kind of been our local lady to help us, through the local things here that we just don't know about it. And if you know my channel, Gloria is as much as of a foreigner as I am.
I know.
So Gloria is definitely not a local lady. So Gloria and I both depend on Davina to help us understand a lot of things. And so fortunately, Jackie is helping Betsye through this maze of living here. This is a somewhat personal thing, but what do you see? What's your plans? In other words, are you planning just to check it out, or are you hoping to stay here?
My plan is this is my home now.
Yeah. Okay.
And maybe visit America every now and then, but basically no.
Yeah.
And I plan on living my life here like I would basically live in. You have a house, you have a home, you have a yard, you have a garden.
Right.
And I've already made friends.
Yeah.
So just having a nice stress-free.
There you go.
I do not want
stress-free life. Yeah. There you go.
Stress-free, calm, just a life.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that's what we all want. A simple life, a stress-free life. You know, especially when you reach a certain age, you know. Well, there goes the ambulance. Anyway, if you have questions for Betsye, maybe you could put it in the comments section. And thanks a lot. I appreciate you following my channel and following Betsye's adventure. Right now, she's not quite at the happily ever after part because, you know, when you first get here, you got to find a place to stay right away. And then, if you've been here a while, then you find a kind of a medium place to stay, which is where she is now. But at least she can take a breath and start looking for a more permanent place to stay. Yeah. So, is there anything that you wanted to say about where you're staying now?
Well, where I'm staying now is lovely. It's a beautiful, beautiful area, lovely homes. I have like an efficiency, I guess if you call them the States, an efficiency, very quiet. A few barking dogs, but you better get used to barking dogs. Here. No chickens, just barking dogs. But it's tree lined, it's peaceful, it's quiet, and the wind blows through the trees. It's lovely, I love it. And that's going to be for the next probably 2 or 3 months, and then I will look for a house.
I have full confidence that that Betsye is going to end up exactly where she wants. That is, in the right neighborhood, in the right house, in the right situation. But I guess the main lesson for everybody is it just takes time.
It does. It takes time. Don't be in a hurry, because it's not going to happen.
Right.
But when you retire, why would you be in a hurry?
Right. We're not in a hurry. Okay, everybody. We're going to wrap it up. Thank you for watching.
Bye-bye.
See you next time. Bye-bye. Betsye, is there anything else that you'd like to add before we wrap up this interview?
Yes, I would like to encourage other women to take the step and come to the Philippines or go wherever your heart wants you to go.
There you go.
Me, it was the Philippines, and don't be afraid. If men can do it, girls, we can do it.
There you go. Amen to that. All right. Talk to you later. Betty. Betsye. Did I say Betty or Betsye?
Sure did. You said Betty.
Okay. Start again. That's a cut.
Cut that one out.
3, 2. Yeah, if I make a mistake, you have to say, hey, my name's not Betty. Bob.
Yeah, that's what I'll start calling you, Bob.
Okay.